You definitely need a few tools for setting up and maintaining a 3D printer. But what if you could just get everything you need in a single convenient package and be ready for all eventualities down the road? That's what the AprintaPro Printer Kit promises, and I've got to say, it's a good start. Also, stick around for a chance to win one for yourself. So at its core, this is a toolkit aimed at 3D printer users. What I'd be looking for here would be some sort of a general light duty assortment, plus some specific tools to handle filament loading, 3D print removal, and maybe print cleanup. AprintaPro also includes some other PrintaFix basic bed adhesive that you can use for glass or aluminum print beds, or even when you want to protect specialty surfaces like PEI. But let's start out with the basic tools included. You get a full set of hex keys, some needle nose pliers, and flush cutters. For the most part, that covers regular maintenance. They're also including this two-sided L wrench, which is a perfect tool for removing E3D sized hot end nozzles. The hex keys are nice, they are the shorter type, which is usually enough, but can leave you longing for more if you need to get into particularly tight crevices. It's also including the larger sizes up to a 10mm one, which you'll practically never use on a 3D printer, since all the screws there are typically maybe up to an M5, which have a 4mm in-hex head. But it does include the tiny 1.5mm type, which you'll need for grub screws on pulleys and hopped gears. The needle nose pliers are my personal favorite type of pliers, which I usually use instead of tweezers. They're just really versatile. The ones included in the PrintaKit are decent, they're not as smooth as Knipex ones obviously, but they're much better than Harbor Freight. Similar story with the flush cutters, which is a tool that usually you don't know you're missing unless you've had one before. In that case, you are going to use it constantly. These are great for shaping filament before inserting it into the printer, since they don't leave that burr behind that regular side cutters introduce, but they're also super useful for snipping off stubborn support materials from your prints. And if you ever get into electronics, you'll use them constantly for trimming off soldered component leads, etc. You also get some round nose tweezers, which, to be honest, I'm not using for much other than picking off hot plastic bits of the nozzle. But hey, they're nice to have around. So that should have maintenance and setup mostly covered. For starting a print, you get that bottle of PrintaFix Basic, which is a small shake and pump bottle with that pearlescent adhesive inside. You do need to give it a really good shake before applying, and thankfully it doesn't have that almost perfumed smell to it that the hairspray-like 3D lac has. That stuff gives me a headache. It's still using flammable isopropyl alcohol and ethanol as solvent, which do smell, but since it's a manual pump bottle, I'd say the risk of anything actually igniting is much lower than with spray cans, since the spray's mist is not as fine, and it's physically harder to spray out a sufficiently large amount of PrintaFix to create a combustible atmosphere. The coarser and less powerful mist also means you won't be soiling your 3D printer with it as easily if you do decide to use it inside the machine, which is still not recommended, but it just won't cover everything with that gooey, sticky white layer. Adhesion is fine, but it's not as crazy as the aforementioned 3D lac, which I've actually managed to tear a piece of glass out of a print bed with, even on a regular PLA print. For ABS and some of the more strongly warping materials, I would recommend using something other than PrintaFix, but for day-to-day use with PLA, etc., it works great. Now, once you finally manage to get that print stuck, there are a few tools that help you with removing it again. And those are this razor blade holder and the sharpened spatula. The general idea is that you'll start up by sliding the razor blade under the edge of a finished print and then follow up with the spatula to completely remove it. I've personally moved on to using a sharp chisel, laying that flat against the bed and then jamming it under the print, but pulling that off without damaging the print or the print surface requires a good bit of practice. The spatula in the PrintaKit is specifically sharpened with a two-sided grind, so it's hard to slide directly under a print, but it's also much harder to damage the print surface should you be using PI or BuildTech or anything like that. And lastly, for print cleanup, you're getting a general purpose hobby knife with a bunch of extra blades. And while I've not found a particularly great tool for removing stuff like tiny blobs or the ridges on the bottom of a 3D print, this sort of a knife plus the flush cutters do a pretty good job of cleaning up a print. To stay safe during cleanup, there's a pair of universal gloves and some safety glasses included. The glasses are great, they are a simple type that fits very closely. You do need to be quite rough at 3D print cleanup to need them, But I think any type of safety glasses or goggles are some of the most underused personal protection measures. Obviously, these don't work great for people already wearing glasses, but yeah. Usually, these are super unintrusive, and if you have a particularly hard-to-remove piece of support material, they definitely do a good job of keeping plastic bits out of your eyes. The gloves, on the other hand, are a standard size. These are size 10, and they are a bit big for my size 8 hands and aren't specifically cut resistant, so I don't see myself using these too much. For cleaning out nozzle clogs, the PrintaKit also includes a few acupuncture needles. But let's be honest, if you use your 3D printer right, you should never need to use these. And to get you on the right track, they are also including a small printed manual with basic tips for the tools and just general 3D printing knowledge, as well as a few of these nozzle adjustment strips. I mean, you could just use a piece of paper instead. So overall, the PrintaKit is kind of a very basic toolkit. It includes a bit of everything, but not the kitchen sink. I can definitely see myself using this in day-to-day service or even for building a fresh 3D printer, maybe with one or two tools added. You know, you always need a few specific tools for specific 3D printers. But of course, you can augment the kit with whatever extra stuff you need. The top of the case has plenty of space if you need to store a few extra wrenches, spanners, different pliers, or a screwdriver. I've seen suggestions of including stuff like a filament oiler, but super specialized stuff like that isn't going to be useful for too many folks. I mean, none of my printers need one, so yeah. Calipers might be nice as they help you getting your CAD designs optimized, but they're not as much of a necessity for everyone anymore as they used to be back when 3D printers were still a bit more of a hack to get a job. The PrintaKit currently sells for 85 euros including sales tax. I think that is still a bit on the expensive side, especially if you already have a few of these tools. Of course, there's that convenience factor of getting everything in one package, as in literally in a nice hard shell case, and that's a good idea to keep all the essentials together, but for all of you hardcore nerds, I don't think the PrintaKit is a good match in the first place. Instead, Absolute 3D Printing and DIY novices that are maybe just building their first 3D printer kit or getting their first rep going could make good use of the PrintaKit. There are schools and universities where you have workshops and classes on 3D printing, and they just have like 20 of these kits, and everyone just gets one of them to use for the machine they are working on. That, I think, is pretty much a perfect fit. So if you're just starting out with 3D printing or are about to get your first machine, here's a chance to win a printer kit for yourself. Enter at toms3d.org/win within the next 2 weeks, and one of these could be yours. The giveaway is open to anyone worldwide, and as usual, ignore any scammers that you see in the video comments who demand shipping charges from you up front. If you win, AprintaPro is going to ship you one of these babies for free. Well, who knows, maybe if you'll win that Cetus from Maker's Muse, a printer kit would go along with that quite nicely. So if this video was helpful to you, give it a thumbs up. If not, leave a comment on what I can improve to make it a better experience for you the next time. And I do mean that. If you have any critique to share, I do read every single comment. Also, make sure you subscribe to the channel and do click that bell, or YouTube might not show you updates as new videos come out and live streams go live. Or head over to Patreon to support the channel directly and get access to monthly Q&A hangouts and more. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.